Twitter elections. Gone are the days when Twitter elections were considered to be a useless approach because the politicians have now started understanding the importance of this platform. In fact, many politicians have already started building their campaigns on Twitter. The reason why the trend is changing so fast is that the new generation spends more time on social media rather than watching the traditional news channels. The companies that carry out different surveys about politicians have also started using the Twitter elections to find out how much credibility a politician has earned during a specific period. The best thing about these elections is that they keep taking place throughout the year. That's just because the companies need to prepare a detailed report about politicians every year. These elections are not just limited to the politicians, but they also help with checking out the credibility of different businesses. The elections that are targeted towards businesses are only popular among the business community. But the elections that are targeted towards politicians make a greater impact because many people are interested in knowing the results of elections before the elections take place in their town/city/country. This is where the Twitter elections give them the opportunity to predict which political party is going to win the election in the next round. Social media platforms wanting to help curb political disinformation on their sites are offering new ways to avoid it online. Twitter has discontinued all political ads and Facebook has new tools for content moderation. This is a good start, even if not all platforms are showing initiative, and not all such attempts are fruitful. Yes, you can simply create a poll on Twitter to predict the results of upcoming elections. However, that can only happen if you have a huge fan following that is interested in local politics. If you don't have a huge fan following, you might have to run an ad to reach out to as many people as possible. But that can be a little bit expensive. This option is only suitable for those who need to conduct Twitter elections only once in a while. But if you want to create polls at different times of the year, you should start using the Twitter data to collect the information you want. You can search for relevant hashtags and keywords to collect data from the internet. The best way to collect data is to use advanced tools because these tools can categorize the data according to your preferences. And they search the data faster than humans. If you're willing to collect data manually, you need to take a look at the following information. Monitor the accounts of politicians. You need to find tweets that are getting more responses than others. Then you need to explore the comment section to see whether people like their implementations or not. You should also keep an eye on how their teams are responding to different users. Also, don't forget to check the number of likes and retweets they're getting on their tweets. Every day a number of political hashtags are launched over the internet. You need to check the tweets in these hashtags to see whether people are happy with the policies of a political party or not. You need to be very good at identifying fake profiles because many political parties have organized their media cells to manipulate the facts on Twitter. Follow the latest trends. If you're trying to conduct Twitter elections during election days, you need to monitor the latest trends carefully. Here you'd find the accurate information to predict the results of upcoming elections. However, you need to hire a few people to monitor the performance of these trends.